If you want to know how to complete all week 10 challenges, go check out the rest of the video. Thanks to FireMonkey, I'm able to give you a full guide on the week 10 Fortnite challenges. They will show up on Thursday, October 29 at 9 AM ET. It's the last set of weekly challenges for this season. I will go live once they come out. Anyways, let's move on to the first challenge of week 10. You have the search chest at upstate New York. For those who don't know where it is, it's the big part of the map inside the red circle. Of course, we have Stark Industries in it. A lot of chests, but even more people landing there. So instead, I would recommend landing around Heart Lake. There are a few buildings around it with a lot of chest spawns. But the best place to go is the building east of the lake. It's the one with the secret Tony Stark lab underneath. Try to land on the roof and pickaxe your way down. There will be two chests hidden underneath. Make your way around the corner for the second one. After you opened it, go down and inside the building, and on your left side you will find another chest. Now go down again until you end up inside the lab, because there are two more chests. So that's already a total of 5. I expect you need to open up 7 chests to complete the challenge. I recommend going in Team Rumble because you have 100% chest spawn in this game mode. And if you go outside, make your way towards the lake for the last 2 chests. The second challenge is to get eliminations at Lazy Lake. Just land there a few times and you should be able to complete the challenge. For the third challenge, you need to collect metal from Slurpee Swamp. Slurpee has a lot of metal scattered around the location, so you should be fine on completing the challenge. But just to make it easier, let me give you some tips. Try to land near the metal fences, because they give you 20 to 30 metal each, and you only have to hit it a few times. On the west side, there are a lot of fences next to each other. But if you're too late and still need some metal, go to the roof of a building. Aim for the metal ledges and you will get a lot of metal as well. And the last trick is to search for chests. Since you already start with 150 metal in Team Rumble, it is very effective. Open the chest and when metal comes out of it, drop your own stack of metal next to it. It will add up to the 30 that came out of the chest. Pick it up and in this case you would have collected over 600 metal in Slurpee Swamp. For challenge number 4, you need to catch fish at Heart Lake. So we have to go to the same location again. There are multiple fishing rod spawns next to the lake. I just randomly picked one of them and it has a fishing hole, so that's good. All you need to do now is start fishing. You could be unlucky fishing weapons like me, but here we go. We got ourselves a flopper and a shield fish. And once all the fishing holes are gone, keep going because you can still catch those small fry. For the next challenge, you need to eliminate opponents by hitting them with vehicles. We already had a similar challenge for the Fort Nightmares event, so you might have been able to practice your skills already. But the good thing is, it also works on Stark robots and henchmen. For my Fort Nightmares challenge, I went to Stark Industries. Because the car had to be possessed, I got myself eliminated early in the match. For the week 10 challenge, you can just directly get inside one of the cars. Now start driving around like a maniac and crush as many robots or real players as you can. Make sure you finish the robots before they get revived or even hacked by an opponent. I'm not sure how many opponents have to be eliminated, but I think it will be something between 2 or 5. On my first attempt, I already managed to eliminate a lot of robots and to be honest, I had a good time. For challenge number 6, you need to drive a boat from the flotilla to the authority in less than 4 minutes. The flotilla doesn't have many motorboat spawns, but you can find one at the yellow crane on the edge of the swamp. In the Fort Nightmares game types, motorboats and choppers are disabled, so you need to go to Team Rumble to complete the challenge. There's only one way to get to the authority, so I hope people aren't going to stand close to the river and shoot at you. First of all, you need to make your way through the swamp. Once you've reached the purple bridge, there's just one river that leads to the end. Keep following this river through Weeping Woods. We've had a lot of vehicle-related challenges this season, most of them with a car. The good thing about the motorboat is that it doesn't have a fuel meter. Anyways, it took me 1 minute and 30 seconds to get to the finish line. The next challenge is a team challenge. You need to ride 20,000 meters in a vehicle. Once completed, you will get 50k XP. You don't have to do this alone. Every meter a teammate drives will help you to complete the challenge. My advice is to go to Stark Industries again, land on one of the supercars, and I recommend using Team Rumble so you can just drive around the map the whole game. Try to stay on the road so you keep your pace and make a lot of meters. Maybe going through a rift is a good tip because you might get a lot of meters in a very short amount of time. Just keep driving around the map. Normally I would say a chopper is better, but they are disabled in all game times during the Fort Nightmares event. And if you're lucky, you might bump right into one of your opponents. Drive over them in case you still need it for one of the earlier challenges. The last challenge is a backup challenge. You need to deal 500 damage to opponents at Sentinel Graveyard. If a challenge doesn't work or can't be completed because of a map change, they will use this as a replacement. Don't expect it to show up on first day, but if it's there, just land there a few times and get some damage. These were all the week 10 challenges, good luck. And if you go to the Battle Pass tab, you will see that we can unlock the tactical style for Mystique. You need to complete challenges from week 9 or 10 to get it. If you've completed all challenges from last week, the counter should say 7 out of 10. So you only need 3 more for this week to get the skin style. I will go live once the challenges come out on Thursday. After I collected all XP coins, I'm going to complete the challenges. Feel free to join the stream and hang out with the community. So leave a like if this video was useful, subscribe to my channel and make sure you turn on notifications so you won't miss a single video. My goal is to reach 10,000 subscribers, so maybe you can help me out. My name is Rutger K, thanks for watching and I see you in the next video.